Hello guys and welcome to Walking Project. I recently hit 5,000 subscribers on my channel and I'm making this video to celebrate that, and I really want to say thanks each one of you guys for the continuous support since I started my channel about 2 years ago. Now, I never thought that it's gonna be that hard to be honest with you to get subscribers and to get noticed, and I still haven't, you know, really reached a level on my channel where things are really starting to take off properly. But I'm hoping that very soon, at the end of the year, hopefully I'm gonna hit 10,000 subscribers, and then from then on things are going to skyrocket for me. And it's not exactly about the fame, but it's just, you know, I've always been trying to, you know, be as honest as possible for you guys. And what I believe in is that you should have a proper, reliable information when buying a phone, and you should, you know, have the chance to watch somebody being honest about the product, because as you already know, most of those channels are already paid. For example, BlackBerry Key 2 now reviews popping up everywhere. The phone is not even available and it's obvious that they're paid reviews, and they're gonna be critical for some things, but overall, they're going to be quite positive about what they say, boosting the sales of the company, cashing out huge checks and this and that. So that's exactly the opposite of what I'm trying to do over here, guys, which is to give you as honest as possible information about a product. But anyway, that's something else. So again, thank you very much for the support, guys. The Amazon affiliate links, the GearBest affiliate links, thanks for shopping. I get small commission out of those links, and that's vital for the channel, because the amount of phones that I've invested money in, you know, greatly surpasses the amount of money that I'm getting from the YouTube revenue. So yeah, that's a huge investment, let's put it this way, huge investment. But I look at it the other way, that everybody has some sort of a hobby, so that's my hobby and I invest my money into that, and hopefully one day I'll be able to make some real income. And if I can do that, if I can do whatever I, you know, feel passionate about full time, that's gonna be simply amazing. But that day is a little bit too far away, so now I better concentrate in celebrating the way I know best, which is giving you guys another throwbacks video of something quite special. Ladies and gentlemen, say hello to the LG New Chocolate BL40. This phone was released in 2009 and it has a 21:9 aspect ratio screen. Check this out, guys. This is absolutely crazy. Even by the today's standard, I think we're at 19.529, something like that, and this one is 21:9. Basically, it's 10 years ahead of its time, guys. It was quite expensive, more or less at the level of the iPhone 3GS, which was released back in the day. Where is the 3GS? Let me give a quick comparison. Yeah, so this is the 3GS. Look how small it is compared to the LG and how thick that is. It looks like a brick. And the resolution of the screen, if I'm not wrong, is 345x800, something like that, which is absolutely crazy compared to even the 3GS, which was considered as a, you know, engineering kind of advanced miracle phone back in the day. And what's very interesting, that this phone actually supports lock screen gestures, guys. Let me show you what I'm talking about. You draw a V over here and it takes you to, let's see, gallery. Can you imagine? 2009, this phone supports lock screen gestures. I believe the one of the first companies to introduce that was OnePlus. With the OnePlus One, you could draw to start flashlight, this and that, and everybody thought that that's a great idea. Well, they probably copied from somewhere, nobody really knew from where. I didn't know at the time as well, but this LG had that 10 years ago, guys. As well as this phone actually had a 5-megapixel pretty good camera, way better than the one on the iPhone over here, as well as it had 1 gigabyte of inbuilt storage plus micro SD support up to 32 gigabytes, which was absolutely crazy for a non-smartphone, because in the end of the day, that's a non-smartphone, guys. It's feature phone. But apart from that, I mean, you had, of course, Wi-Fi, multitasking. You had multitasking. Can you imagine, guys? Multitasking in a non-smartphone phone. As well as you had Java support of games. As well as you had, let me show you quickly. It takes a little bit of time. Now, everything on this phone, it takes a little bit of time. And if you read the reviews online, everybody's saying that basically everything takes a little bit of time on this phone, guys. And that's true. I mean, for a non-smartphone running, basically you've got a full browser over here. Yeah, let's open up Google. Google. Come on, man. Wi-Fi. Okay, anyway, let me show you something. Now you've got the regular keyboard like that, and when you switch the phone like that, you have a full screen keyboard, guys. Can you imagine? 2009 full screen keyboard. And the other thing is that you have, you know, widgets. Can you imagine? You have widgets on this phone, guys. You can set up different wallpapers for the different screen, but over here you've got widgets, which is crazy. And as well as when you go to the menu over here, you can flip the phone like that. And check this out, the applications are automatically reordering themselves according to, let's see, communications, entertainment, utilities, settings, this and that. And one other weird feature of this phone, that it had actually an FM transmitter. If you have an old car like mine, 20 years old, and you don't have a CD changer, basically you're stuck with the old cassettes and with FM, but this one has FM transmitter, which means that you can play your own music and it transmits a frequency on the FM, and basically you can use that as an MP3 player, which back in the day only, let's see, only a few Nokia models had actually, and LG, I think 2 or 3 models of LG did that, and basically nobody else. Even by the today's standards, very few phones have actually FM transmitters. I haven't really, you know, did the research on the subject. Probably there is an app you can download, this and that. But I mean, with the today's modern smartphones, that's kind of expected to have that functionality. But with this old phone, that's absolutely crazy to have these functions, guys. So yeah, the phone was quite expensive, I believe £450 here in the UK. The iPhone 3GS was retailing for more or less the same money. But I guess if you wanted to be, you know, kind of trendy, and if you concentrated on design, check the buttons over here, guys. That's just crazy. It's, man, one other thing, micro USB charging port in 2009. I don't know if you knew that LG was one of the first companies to implement this universal standard back in the day, because literally nobody else was having a micro USB charging port, but LG was one of the very few companies who actually implemented that feature. So basically, yeah, I'm a huge LG fan. I've got quite a few LG phones, excuse me. Oh, I bit my tongue. Oh man. Not nice. Anyway, let me wipe my teeth. Yeah. Alright, that was painful. Right, so, yeah, the phone was absolutely crazy. I've got a few more crazy LG phones. Let me know in the comment section below, guys, are you interested at all in this sort of phones on my channel? But yeah, I definitely am, and LG was one of the very few companies which has never been afraid to, you know, try new functions, new crazy ideas. And I'm kind of a little bit feeling sorry for them, especially the recent few years that they've been kind of struggling and they don't innovate that much. Apart from the wide-angle camera, they're the only ones who are offering a proper wide-angle camera. But anyway, guys, that's about it for today's video. Thank you so much for watching and for your continuous support. And yeah, see you in the next one. Adios. Oh, by the way, make sure you follow me on Instagram TV, the new application. I'm going to be doing a quick update over here. So yeah, that's about it, guys. Thank you very much for watching and see you later.